previously on Raw Danger. Hello and welcome back to Nathan Plays Raw Danger. My name is Nathan and this is Raw Danger for the PlayStation 2. I confess it's been a really long time since I recorded this footage and I had some trouble remembering what the game was about, so let's recap. It's Christmas time, I'm a guy named Joshua, that's Stephanie McMurrow, the daughter of a very rich man. Everything floods and there's a catastrophe in the underground city of Geo City, which is beneath the city of Del Rey. Ah, that's the mayor. Yeah, it's all coming back to me. I recorded the footage for this episode way back in April 17th, says the timestamps, and I did not get around to editing it right away, and then I forgot. Just, some projects just kind of fall by the wayside for a while, but recently I dusted it off, unearthed it, and thought, let's revive this and finish up Joshua's chapter, and then maybe, keep going through the rest of the game. I think we had a good break. In the flooded city. Oh yeah, it's all coming back to me now. It's all here. Everyone's fate crosses. Perfect. I trust that if that wasn't enough of a refresher for you, you can head back to the other videos on the YouTube there. Meanwhile, we're gonna jump in. So I had a fabulous pirate hat, and we're hanging out in a circus tent, repurposed for the sake of sheltering people as we wait for our rescue. And just before I saved it here, there appeared to have been a bit of a landslide outside around some houses, and Stephanie and another man had gone out there to take a look. But I went back inside to get warm. Now let's go check it out. It was around the side of the tent here. Man, that's a great hat. And where are those folks? Here we go.
God, you're here. Please help me carry this person. Of course I'll help. Thanks. Let's get him onto a stretcher.
Of course. Why wouldn't I help?
Let's bring him to the tent.
So we have a stretcher, and I have to say that the guy that I'm carrying this with is eerily in tune with my movements. Like, he's incredibly sensitive to the way I move, and the center of gravity seems a little bit strange, but we'll let it slide. Bring him back inside here. Hopefully Stephanie goes back inside too. I'm not the boss of her, I guess. She's a grown-up. She can decide to go for warmth or not.
Nothing too critical, but her body is very cold. Please bring her something hot to eat. There's some soup in the RV parked in the tent out back. Get there by going through here.
Well, I haven't been on the clock for a couple of days now in my waiter job, but I guess I can help out. I'll head back there and go see what I can find. This isn't quite the catering facility that I'm used to working at, but I suppose we have to make do under the circumstances. Let's see here. Oh, whoa. Okay, there's the RV. Found it. Found the wrong side. And here we go. There's a cooking surface there if I should need it, but I don't. And I obtained a meal. And a nice tray and everything. Hmm? So of course you can't run while you're carrying a meal or you'll ruin everything. So I carefully and painstakingly made my way back to the survivors here.
Wonderful.
Well, there's nothing really.
Much better now. She'll be all right then. Thank you for your help.
Excuse me, do you know a woman named Claire Wyatt?
I believe she's in the RV out back.
Really? Oh. Thank you.
That's
so
handy.
Much.
Stephanie heads off in a wide, sweeping arc. And because I'm nosy and have nothing better to do, I decide to follow. Here she is outside the RV. What's on your mind, Steph?
Excuse me. I was told there's a woman named Claire Wyatt here.
Who are you? Are you family?
Yes, I am.
Sorry. I hate to tell you this, but she doesn't have much time left.
Oh no,
see her right away.
I don't remember what her issue is. Has
looks like
taken
Steph
its toll.
Sure.
And after every other time that I've reassured her about this course of action.
Yeah.
She still isn't sure. I guess it's hard. I don't know what it's like. But I told her to head in, and so she does. Out of respect, and because I don't want to get involved, I decided to just stay outside and watch. When apparently that means just standing in the doorway and staring inside, which means I can more or less overhear everything anyway. Oh, she's doing that meme.
Excuse me? Thank you for coming all this way. What? I can't imagine the trouble you've been through to find me. I hope I know how you feel. You do?
Aw.
You feel so guilty about everything, and you're not sure what to do. If you feel a little better blaming me, it's okay. You can hate me.
Wow.
How can I... Poor thing. I was a horrible daughter. I didn't know what to do. Don't worry. I'm so happy you came here.
Oh, see, there we go. We made the right call.
Please, don't blame yourself anymore. Take care of your father.
And just as reconciliation is given, she fades away. As always, say not in grief she is no more, but live in gladness that she ever was. Back outside, there's me in my hat. I feel slightly inappropriate right now. I don't know what to say. She was happy to see you. Well, I don't know about that. You told her what you wanted to say. I'm glad I was here for you. Or gently hug her. Am I saying that to her? Like, am I going to tell her to gently hug her mom?
I don't know what to say.
Anyway, I went with, I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything. It's okay. Because of you, I was able to see my mom.
Yeah, because of me. Are we $75, please?
Could you leave me alone?
Oh, yeah, I guess that makes sense. Okay. Well, job well done. I'm just gonna sit cross-legged on the ground here and wait for salvation. Or I'll head back in the tent to warm up again. Everybody's gone. Well, that's curious. Of course, I never miss an opportunity to warm up. So after doing that, I decide to head outside and see if they've gone out this entrance.
Hey everyone, the rescue helicopter is here.
Oh, right on. Oh boy. Oh geez. And the helicopter sinks into the sea. Oh, geez. Time to run. Oh, no. Okay, dodge those. And let's take our sweet time climbing that. Man, oh, man, oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. Whoa, bus. I mean, RV. Whatever. Steph seems to have made it. I don't know where everybody else ended up. Hope they're okay. We're going this way now. This piece of fence has... will serve as a platform. Sheesh, I'm glad you got your emotional closure just in time there, Steph. You don't know how lucky you are.
Oh,
Oh, man, that just figures.
Typical. I feel like I could come up with a stronger response than that, maybe if I were in that same situation. Probably I would just cuss a lot more, so maybe his response is better.
It's my father! Dad! Mom! Mom is...
No, Steph, pick your moments there.
Dad!
What? It's...
Yeah, I don't know what he's referring to. So I just sort of picked something arbitrarily. Control center sounded cool. Let's do that.
It's the Capital Island Control Center.
Huh? It's the media tower.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. If I've been paying attention to the intro,
looks like he's telling us to go there.
The media tower is the center of town.
All right, Steph. Let's go to the media tower.
Media tower.
Okay.
And so, off we go. As you can see, the flood map is showing that this town is in really bad shape right now, and even the only non-dark blue area is still a pretty dark shade of blue. The entire city underwater, says the news alert in the corner. And it's also gotten terribly, terribly cold, apparently. It's 20 after 6 on day 3, and we're on the train tracks. We can't move very fast on the train tracks, and it's really, really cold and windy here. But we're gonna do our best. Steph is dressed even worse than I am. So I do feel kind of bad for her. Throughout this area, I skip a decent chunk of it because it goes pretty slowly. I used a good amount of my first aid kits and hot pads to try and stave off the cold. But as you can see, it's pretty unrelenting out here. Occasionally, while you're on the tracks, you're required to climb up or down the ladder to switch levels and make progress. And I'm still impressed with the way this game sells the cold. Further up, we climbed back up to the upper level. I guess that's kind of a confusing transition there now that I look at it. And turned around to find... Oh, nice. New train compass. Yeah, we're putting that on. I was getting a little tired of the thundercloud anyway. I mean, it's been months that it's been on there. Moving on to the end of this section of train track, I made a pretty perilous jump onto the edge of a building. Check out my cute mittens there. Still got those going for me. And I'm pretty well soaked, as you can see by the logo, the thing in the corner, but thanks to the first aids and the heating pads, I'm able to keep my extremities from freezing entirely. Stephanie's on her way down. I hope she can make it across this. It's kind of a jump. Took a moment to look at the rest of the city, which is in pretty bad shape, all things considered. And because I always forget which one's the yell and which one's the crouch, hey! I crouched before yelling.
Steph!
Oh man, we made it. Steph is doing really unwell at this point, so after using another first aid kit to warm up, I decided to give her a hug. I saved her life, apparently. Well, that's what I'm here for. Yes. Making our way further along, we found this entry into a small rooftop room here. It's got a couple of items kicking around. And I heard a noise off to the side. The familiar hiss of a heater. Oh, perfect. Finally able to get dry. We shared a meal together. And then I was able to look around and see what else was in the room. We have some beef stew in a box. That's probably good. Probably fine. And off to the side. It's another heating pad to replace the one I've used. My inventory is still pretty full. On this difficulty mode, they've been very generous with the items, which is nice. You really don't have to go too far out of your way to find a lot of this stuff. And I'm sure I bypassed a lot of things as well. Explored the area a little bit more. And then decided to move on by jumping onto this very precarious looking train car. In doing so, I wrecked my pants, as you saw, and I tried to see if I had another pair, which I don't. And at that point, I just decided to take stock of the rest of my inventory a little bit, which I've kind of skipped over here, as well as giving some spare boots I had to Stephanie. So she's got some nice lace-up boots right now. This is not a great situation to be in. I think we can all agree upon that. But it looks like there's kind of a way off this thing. If only this doofy fella quit falling off the side for a moment. Stephanie's got it. She's fine. I'm just gonna have the best time in the world trying to climb down from here. That's what I'm up to right now. And then I managed to hurt myself again. Perfect. And here's a ladder. A little further on the train tracks, and then this starts happening. Oh, it's probably fine. Oh, wait. Time to run, everybody. Normally, I try to use the run button pretty sparingly, because you only have so much stamina and so on. But in times like this, you really gotta hoof it, except for when you can't quite find the way onto the ladder. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. And another very near miss for Team Josh and Steph, but we're not out of danger yet. And then I fell on my bum. The water is still rising, following right behind us, as you can see. But I did my best cruise missile impersonation. That's Tom Cruise in any Mission Impossible film. And we made it.
Go!
Again, for all the kind of wonkiness in the animation and the voice acting and things like that, the game does a curiously good job of selling cold and wet. Like, it's a cold feeling game to play. Somehow, the sound and the wind ripping around there. As a person who lives in a very cold place for a lot of the year, it's believable. There's the helicopter making a landing in the storm somehow. Steph is still not great.
Steph seems tired.
I have one last chance to ditch her or yell at her for holding me back. But I decide to be encouraging. Just too nice, I guess. So we make our way onto the train platform where we found some stairs that head down. Spoiler alert, got a little ahead of myself there. Seemingly not much else around. And again, because we can't move all that terribly quickly, not the most exciting thing ever to watch. down in the underground section here. Seems to have flooded a little bit. We're going to rock a heat pad just to protect ourselves against the cold. Let's see if we can navigate this. Hopefully Steph's right behind us. Haven't really checked in a while. She'll be fine, right? This water looks awfully dirty. Oh yeah, there she is. For once, I was actually prepared to crouch and hang on when something rumbled, and then nothing happened. I crouched a couple of more times, partly for safety and partly because it's funny that he makes that noise every single time. But the one time I was actually ready... Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? That's what's gonna happen here. Fine. Whatever. Oop. Well, we don't have our JR passes handy. So we're gonna jump the turnstile. Hopefully no one's around to see this. That's a nice Christmas tree. And Christmas tree's down. And apparently it was incredibly heavy. Look what it did to the floor. It's got a solid titanium core something. Maybe titanium is really light and I sound stupid right now. I don't know. But it had some presence underneath. Presence in the form of, I believe, another first aid kit. Yes. So what's kind of interesting is that finding these things and the heating pad... Finding these things might make a person think that there's a lot more to Joshua's chapter, because why would they give you restoratives right at the end of it? Right? But it turns out they gave you restoratives right at the end of it. We made it to the chopper.
Father!
Stephanie!
Steph is finally reunited with her dad, and
Father.
They embrace.
Mom is dead.
Whoa. Steph, learn some tact.
Father.
Let's go.
I'm just gonna hang out here awkwardly in the background, you guys. No big deal. Though if I could get a ride on that chopper, that'd be much appreciated. So that is the end of Joshua's chapter. We get a little epilogue here that sums up our actions, called Notes of a Survivor, Joshua Harwell.
What happened at the East Junction?
It's hard to hear over the wind, but he is narrating.
She said she was happy to see me. After that, we started calling each other Steph.
Hey, I never got a cutesy nickname. J-Town? J-Pack? I don't know.
When we arrived at the circus tent, I said... Do you hear me? Condition of
Clearwater. I'm not really sure what I mean by that.
It's very bad. Still not sure, even after seeing Claire. Claire still cared about Stephanie. And she quietly took her last breath.
See, I wouldn't have known this if I hadn't eavesdropped. That's the power of eavesdropping, everybody.
Stephanie saying, my mom. My mom. And just kept crying.
There we go, touching in. You get a survivor certificate. I survived. Got ending pattern type 1A, so I suppose there are lots of other endings, which makes sense given the dialogue options. It took me 3 hours. Didn't even die. And I traveled 10 miles. Wow. And my jewelries are unknown. I didn't know there were jewelries to know. I didn't know this at all. Hopefully in one of the future chapters, I will receive known jewelries. After a traditional save of my progress, you can also save the epilogue, which I guess allows you maybe to go back and experience different versions of it or something. So I did. After exiting saving, I got a little preview of the next chapter here, which I will tease you with. The player is Amber Brazil, a sophomore murder suspect, who looks suspiciously similar to a young lady that we helped out way earlier on in our run of Joshua's story. So maybe we'll get to see how that all ties together. But for now, thanks for watching, thanks for your patience, and we'll see you next mission.